Right.
Anything into these organs. We then actually bring our waste around. We have a waste transfer station, and that's something that our colleagues from UNEP, who are here with me, have developed.
The city of Kuju has a population of over 10 million people. They have established a comprehensive solid waste management system. The National Action Plan 2017-2036, the Institute of Cuba, you have now been awarded the UN Habitat Scroll of Honor. Congratulations. The next is our own Mistry Risma Harini, Mayor of Surabaya City, Indonesia, for implementing people-centered and inclusive city regeneration and developing initiatives. Mr. Isaac Kakamuasa, our own here in Kenya, Chairman, Mathare Environmental Conservation Youth Group, for harnessing the potential of disadvantaged youth and inspiring community-wide involvement in solid waste management. Posthumously, for all the good work that she has done in the globe, in Sub-Saharan Africa, Eastern Europe, Middle East and North Africa, Central Asia, Latin America and the Caribbean in promoting sustainable urbanization.
And other waste management. Every year, we dispose 2 billion tons of waste. This is almost 1 kilogram of waste per person per day. Each of us play a role in generating this waste, which also means that each of us can play a fundamental role in reducing and rethinking the way we consume and dispose our individual waste. UN Habitat looks forward to working together with the county governments in addressing their municipal waste and also the challenges, including integrating waste pickers in the waste collection system, provide a key service in unhealthy and dangerous condition. We also promise to work together with Nairobi, Mombasa, and Kisumu. I would like to share with you a few ideas on ways I think we can collectively address waste management. First, tackling our waste management challenges requires imagination and innovation. So during my time as a mayor in Penang, I introduced the idea of rethinking of waste management to complement the 3 R of reducing, reusing, and recycling. So instead of allowing waste to a simple waste, a different approach of concept of waste was introduced. Through this shift in mindset and practice, our rate of recycling increase and reduce waste ending in the landfill and the cost borne by the citizen. Second, leading by example. We are here, should lead by example, and change start from individual. Educating our children and ensuring the school curricula fully embrace reduce, reuse, recycle approach is very fundamental. Third, working with the private sector on how they can buy back recycled products which can be transformed into new items at home, the fashion industry, building construction material, food industry, and so on. And fourth is holding city administration accountable to play the role of enabling and facilitating waste management behavior change. This is very, very important. For this reason, UN Habitat is more than ever committed in making cities inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable. In here in Kenya, UN Habitat is working closely with the government and other partners such as World Bank, to support implementation of the second pillar of the Big Four, the pillar on the affordable housing, sir.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted to join you this morning to mark this year's global observance of the World Health Day 2018. We, as a country, appreciate the honor once again to co-host this event after a lapse of so many years. To all our distinguished guests, let me say, Karibu Nairobi, Karibu Kenya. Let me also take this early opportunity to underscore that we indeed feel proud of co-hosting this event with our brothers and sisters from Indonesia, represented here by, among others, the Mayor of Surabaya. Madam Mayor, we are delighted to have you with us. Please feel very much at home amongst your Kenyan brothers and sisters. Ladies and gentlemen, it is important that we appreciate the tireless work that Habitat and indeed UNEP do to help us all meet the challenges of development. We in Kenya are proud to be their hosts. I also take this early opportunity to congratulate you, Madam Maimuna Sharif, for your appointment as Undersecretary and Executive Director of UN Habitat. I assure you that my administration will render its support to you so that you can succeed in performing your duties, and in particular, that of the United Nations Human Settlement Program. Ladies and gentlemen, the subject matter we gather to deliberate on indeed deserves our urgent attention. Today, the world's population lives, half the world's population lives in cities. And by 2030, 706 towns and cities will have over 1 million people each. Neither Africa, and indeed Kenya, have been or will be spared that growth. And we expect that by 2030, 40% of Africa's population will be living in towns and cities. For our country, Kenya, the urban population is already at 30% and growing. These trends in urbanization, coupled with changes in consumption, have left us a problem that will only grow more pressing, and that is the problem of solid waste. I am informed that across the world, municipal solid waste currently exceeds 2 billion tons a year. But it isn't the sheer amount of waste that is troubling, though it is impressive enough. The composition of the waste, its disposal, and the threat it poses to the health of our people and their environment ought to trouble us more. There is no doubt at all, the problem is enormous and growing. And this is a problem we must share. We therefore need to work together to find innovative as well as sustainable solutions. I believe therefore that this year's municipal solid waste management theme is timely. Solid waste management poses one of the greatest challenges of our time in a rapidly urbanizing world, and we must take urgent action. I equally believe each one of us has a role to play in ensuring sustainability, clean environments, habitable cities and communities where all of us can thrive. We are lucky to have a number of international agreements which will provide useful guidelines as we walk this journey. The 11th Sustainable Development safe, resilient, and sustainable. It is complemented by the fifth target of the 12th goal, which asks us to substantially reduce waste generation through prevention, reduction, recycling, and reuse by 2030. We also have with us the new urban agenda adopted nearly 2 years ago in Quito, which sets out new standards for cities. It asks, in relevant part, that we promote environmentally sound waste management and that we cut waste by reusing, recycling, or converting it to energy wherever we can. The goals are clear, and as Madam Undersecretary has stated, now is the time to act. Let me just mention a little bit about the work that we're doing here in Kenya, in the hope that it will be useful to others who find themselves in a similar situation. After extensive consultation, my administration put together the National Environmental Policy in 2014. And I'm pleased that we have a clear now and detailed set of rules for the management of Kenya's environmental and natural resources. The guidelines enable the National Solid Waste Management Strategy 2015, which is our national plan for solid waste management. At the moment, we are working with our county governments to agree on county plans, the better way to agree on county plans, the better way to achieve our national goals. Ladies and gentlemen, it would not be right for me to discuss solid waste management without touching on my administration's Big Four agenda, which focuses on universal health, food security, manufacturing, and affordable housing. In essence, this agenda targets households, families, decent jobs, adequate food supplies, as well as decent housing, which translates to better health for our citizens. Our affordable housing agenda is a comprehensive program targeting delivery of 500,000 housing units by 2022. It will involve installation of infrastructure and sanitary facilities, including management of solid waste, especially at the household level. Indeed, it is my conviction that our goal is attainable. I call upon the UN Habitat to provide expertise and advice, not only to Kenya, but to other member states, so as to ensure the principles of housing affordability and adequacy are upheld on projects we implement. Our goal is attainable, and we will reach it even faster if friends and partners in Habitat share the deep fund of expertise and experience that they have accumulated over the years. I am particularly pleased to note the ongoing solid waste project in Kisii County, which is supported by UN Habitat. In addition to solid management, the project aims at creating jobs for young men and women through recycling the waste. I also wish to commend the Nairobi County for spearheading and sustaining a monthly cleanup exercise in various parts of our capital, and for initiating a biodigestion project for the youth by using waste to generate gas. And so are doing it on site. I don't know whether matters will be agreed. We can go, it's okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we cannot just rest there. I believe building capacity is an important dimension of waste management. And as we know, global challenges call for global responses. Waste, although produced locally, is impacting negatively on land as well as marine life. Globalization of the local and localization of the global is our new normal. It is for this very reason my administration has agreed with the Canadian government to co-host the Sustainable Blue Economy Conference from the 26th to the 28th of November this year. I'm pleased pleased to note that UN Habitat and UNEP, together with other UN agencies and entities, are also on board. Let me conclude my remarks, ladies and gentlemen, by once again urging each one of us to take personal responsibility in managing waste, indeed starting from the household level. We should all be good ambassadors in delivering this message to our neighbors and friends. Responsibility, as we have been told, begins with you and me. And once upscaled, it results in a positive impact in our immediate environment and eventually in our lives and our cities. I once again commend Madam Maimuna Mohad Sharif, Undersecretary, for the vigor you have brought to the organization since you took up office in January of this year. Your passion and commitment to strengthen UN Habitat as a focal point for sustainable urbanization and human settlement is unparalleled, and indeed I understand it extends to going to our informal settlements like Madaria and Kibira, playing football with the girls there. For this, we are thankful. I assure you of Kenya's support and urge all member countries to support you, in particular on the reforms that you are undertaking to reposition this organization. These few remarks, I wish you all well in the remaining activities of the day and in your endeavors as we continue to observe this important day. Thank you, and may God bless you. Thank you very much.